the heavier you are in general, the life expectancy of the prosthesis is shortened. And so, you know, we have, and every doctor's a little bit different as far as what weight limits that he has. I would tell you that if I do a total hip on a patient that weighs 90 pounds, there are different risks and concerns than on a patient that weighs 350 pounds. So there are risks both ways, but the risk generally that we worry about is longevity of the prosthesis. But understand that the heavier you are, it's more force. Remember I said that initially that every time you lose 10 pounds, you take 100 pounds of force off of your knees. Well, it works the other way too. Every time you've gained 10 pounds, you add 100 pounds of force on your knees. Now, it also adds to your back, your hips, your ankles, and your feet, but we're talking about knees now. So there's no one line that says nobody will operate on you if you're over 250 pounds or if you weigh over 350 pounds. Each doctor has his own limits. But the point being is that if you want that prosthesis to last, if you want an easy post-operative course, if you want a safe return to all your activities, you'll lose as much weight as you can before your surgery, or at least commit yourself to knowing how to do it. You know, we're as surgeons not here to punish you because you're overweight, but we are here to explain to you the consequences of being overweight. We often in our office see patients, and I tend to ask them what the women weighed when they graduate from high school, what the fellas weigh when they were 21, because the difference is that girls are generally done growing when they graduate from high school. Boys will grow until they're about 21. But if you gain 100 pounds from the time you graduated from high school or you were 21, you know, that's a causative factor for you to have arthritis that hurts. So if you want the prosthesis to last, you've got to start losing some weight.